And when I was introducing you a minute ago, I said that you were a guy who could really pick, knows a good song when he hears it. So why don't we do one of those songs that you like a lot together?
I would love to. This has been one of my favorite songs my entire life, so I would love to sing this.
Ladies, why don't you kick it off? Let me hear the amen.
Well, when I was a kid, I'd take a trip every summer down to Mississippi to visit my granny and her antebellum world. I'd run barefooted all day long, climbing trees free as a song. One day, I happened to catch myself a squirrel. Well, I stuffed him down in an old shoebox and punched a couple holes in the top. And when Sunday came, I snuck him into church. Well, I was sitting way back in the very last pew, showing him to my good buddy Hugh, when that squirrel got loose and went totally berserk. Now what happened next is hard to tell. Some thought it was heaven, others thought it was hell, but the fact that something was among us was plain to see. As the choir sang, "I surrender all," the squirrel run apart, Newman's coveralls, and Harv jumped his feet and said, "Something's got a hold on me." All the day the squirrel went berserk in the First Self-Righteous Church in that sleepy little town of Pascagoula. It was a fight for survival that broke out in revival. They were jumping pews and shouting, "Hallelujah,
hallelujah."
Well, Harv hit the aisle dancing, screaming. Some thought he had religion, others thought he had a demon. Harv thought he had a weed eater loose in the Fruit of the Loom. Fell to his knees to plead and beg. The squirrel ran out of his britches leg unobserved to the other side of the room. All the way down to the amen pew where sat Sister Bertha, better than you, who'd been watching all the commotion with sadistic glee.
Shoot, you should have seen the look in her eyes when that squirrel jumped her garters and crossed her thighs. She jumped her feet and said, "Lord, have mercy on me." As the squirrel made laps inside her dress, she began to cry and then to confess to sins that would make a sailor blush with shame. She talked of gossip and church dissension, but the thing that got the most attention was when she talked about her love life. Then she started naming names. The day the squirrel went berserk in the First Self-Righteous Church in that sleepy little town of Pascagoula. It was a fight for survival that broke out in revival. They were jumping pews and shouting, the pastor got saved and $25,000 got raised and 50 volunteered for missions in the Congo on the spot. And even without an invitation, there were at least 500 rededications, and we all got rebaptized whether we needed it or not. Now you've heard the Bible story, I guess, how he parted the waters for Moses to pass, all the miracles God has brought to this old world. But the one you'll remember till your dying day is how he put that church back on the narrow way with a half-crazed Mississippi squirrel. The day the squirrel went berserk in the First Self-Righteous Church in that sleepy little town of Pascagoula. It was a fight for survival that broke out in revival. They were jumping pews and shouting, "Hallelujah,
hallelujah."
They were jumping pews and shouting, "Hey, hallelujah." Hallelujah, brothers and sisters.